Because I think as of now, what I'm hearing is that the Karnataka government is hoping that, you know, this matter sort of dies away from media attention. We move on to other things. We do a survey on the UPA. We talk about other issues. Maybe we talk about the IPL, focus on that, forget all of this. And then at the end of the day, the matter gets shelved and the government can forget about it, maybe set up a subcommittee 10 years later. My question, I'm coming to you, Ganesh. My question to Dr. Dubeshi, former IAS officer, is death got to be the price of honesty, Mr. Dubeshi? What are your views on this particular case of the killing of Mahantesh?
Well, I think this is a very great tragedy, not only for the family with whose sorrow we share, but also it reflects very badly on public administration that a civil servant is not able to do his duties without fear and favor. And a civil servant has to pay with life for performing his duties. This is a very sad reflection on the standard of government and standard of public administration. It is necessary that we create an atmosphere where the civil servant is able to perform his duties without fear or favor. And the criminal elements, we seem to be getting the better of the civil service, should be dealt with severely and put down.
I wish that were the case. As of now, there is not even symbolic action. Not even symbolic action has happened in this case, sir. Yes, Ganesh. Ganesh, you were saying something.
It appears that the father
actually
Mahantesh told us that for 45 minutes the police did not make an appearance.
Yes.
And despite the lapse of several days after the tragedy, there has been no attempt to get the clues. The clues are not there. This seems to be going on very lackadaisically, and I think the citizens must put pressure on government
exactly
to ensure that the criminals are brought to book and severely punished for their misdeeds. And we have to create an atmosphere where the criminals dare not do such things again. This is not for the first time that an event of this sort has taken place in Karnataka.
I cannot agree more with you, but only a
few days back, one Mr.
I remember that other case. Yes, go ahead.
Yes?
No, I remember the other case you were mentioning. Yes, please go ahead.
Now,
you see, only a few days back, another officer, Mr. Nayak, of the Forest Department, had also to pay with his life for doing his work. I think this cannot be tolerated, and the citizens must take the government to account for this severe
Yes, Ganesh. Yes, Ganesh.
After
6 days of this hospital suffering, after 6 days, the Home Minister came on this thing now, and today he declared that there is a personal angle to it, and the police seems to be pursuing only the personal angle mainly, and you know, like, it could be even true, but what they are attempting to do basically is that kill this house building cooperative society's issue totally, connecting the whole issue with Mahantesh. That is what is a worry. You know, like, they could succeed in really, you know, like, getting a personal angle to Mahantesh's death. But what happens is they would like to really link up and say, see, we have investigated and it's all over, it's all personal, and there is no more issue with the house building cooperative society.
You're saying they're trying to cover up the story now. They're trying to cover it up now, saying there was some personal angle which can never be proven.
It could be either that way or cover up the whole scam with his death, establishing the personal this thing. They may settle and close the case saying that it's a personal angle, and the whole scam should not get covered up also.
Who's investigating the scam right now? Nobody.
Even if...
Nobody is investigating the scam now. They don't want to talk about it, Mr. Alphonse. They don't even want to talk about it. They don't want to acknowledge it.
Yeah, I think two things.
This tragedy has taken place on a very...
The way they are going about the scam is very clear.
Say that the investigation has gone nowhere. Now, the police says there is no CCTV footage available there because there was no CC camera there. But I'm surprised because this is right in front of the Chief Justice's house. Okay, if it's not there, it's not there, but it should have been there. Number two, of course, they say that there are no eyewitnesses. Now, obviously, so it's a difficult case, and it's just, it's a few days. Obviously, they are investigating. It's not time for us to write off and say the state.
No, I don't see any investigation. I'm sorry.
I'm sure they're investigating.
Mr. Alphonse.
The bigger issue is,
Mr. Alphonse.
We should not push the bigger issue of.
Mr. Alphonse, today the government of Karnataka is scared to come out and link Mahantesh's killing to the scams that he was investigating. It is scared to make that link because admitting that link might mean opening up a Pandora's box.
One of the scams obviously which he was investigating is regarding the BEML society, housing society, about which certain persons in the Prime Minister's office also has been linked to that scandal. You must have read about that. I mean, the Principal Secretary to the Prime Minister, his relatives have got plots there. And therefore, I guess it's just not a local issue. I think it goes much beyond that. Anybody who can grab things in this country is grabbing things.
Mr. Alphonse, you are being sympathetic right now. You're making it political. Now you're becoming wearing the political hat. You're making it political. You're saying other people could, but you are covering up for the fact that your Karnataka government today is looking the other way. That your Karnataka government, in fact, till it was pushed by the media 2 weeks back in the other case, which was spoken about by Mr. Dubeshi, also in that case did nothing till the media pushed it. But this is a bigger scam, isn't it, Sumaira? This scam is not one that you can cover up. And I've said it tonight on the News Hour that at least on this channel, Times Now will continue to follow the case of Mahantesh, however embarrassing it might prove to be for the Karnataka government. Sumaira. You think the police can just get away here saying, I'm sorry, we have no clue?
No, you should pursue it. I think it's wonderful that the media is pursuing it. I think it's a fantastic thing.
No, I'm absolutely amazed that after every single attack and killing, we still, with the same air of absolute novelty, come out and make a statement saying, oh, a whistleblower has been killed. We must investigate. We must find out. But unfortunately, in this particular case, we don't have any evidence. This has happened
What evidence can a family which has lost its breadwinner provide? What evidence will the young children of Mahantesh, will his young family go out and provide if the state does not do it, Mr. Alphonse? It's the state which must take it up as its responsibility to expose the bigger scam.
See, Prime Minister, I think we need to go beyond rhetoric. The Prime Minister on the Civil Services Day, less a week back, said, officers, now stand up and speak your mind, do your things. Mr. Prime Minister, may I ask you, are you willing to protect officers? Are you willing to protect officers? What did you do when I was beaten up, my wife was beaten up? Did you catch anybody in the capital of the country? 200 people attacked me and my wife and my children. Was one person arrested? You can have big rhetoric, Mr. Prime Minister and everybody else. Sorry, we need to act. This country needs to act. Every case. That's what we need to do. We got away. We are
somewhere,
a soft state. We are tolerating nonsense.
Somewhere,
that is why things like this,
somewhere,
like this happen.
Somewhere
we
deep
must have
within.
A state which will deliver, which will protect and say, officer, go ahead, do your duty.
So somewhere deep within, you know, I just feel that there's a scam linked to every other scam. And my worry is, Sumaira, and I'm saying this openly tonight, that have we become too self-centered as a nation now, you know? That we are only bothered about things that affect us, that we feel Mahantesh is happening somewhere far away, that Mr. Nayak, you know, he was killed somewhere far away. It's his family that pays the price. We don't individually suffer. You know,
I think we are all individually suffering, but we have not yet come to the point where we're willing to acknowledge.
But why would this not become a huge campaign in Bangalore, you know, justice for Mahantesh? You think it has the potential to?
I think it certainly has the potential.
I would like to stress on a point about the individual suffering.
Yes, yes, Ganesh.
And now, you know, it is because of this scam today, I and as an ordinary person or anybody cannot buy a site worth of 30, 40, which costs hardly 400 rupees per square feet, is shot up to 4,000 rupees because of this scam. And today BDA is inactive. They don't have lands to offer for ordinary people. And housing board is inactive. And these cooperative societies are doing in a very big way the layouts. And it's all been allotted to all VIPs, all big people.
You know,
how is that becoming possible? So we are individually affected. just that we are not aware.
Well, you know,
we are not aware that we are affected.
Sumaira knows about it today because in 2010, in the same year that she escaped an attack on her life, that there was another person in Nanded who was stoned to death when he took on the Sand Mafia. Now, I am simply asking this question tonight. If you're watching this in Bengaluru, if you're watching this wherever, do you care enough about the way Mahantesh was killed? Do you know the Mr. Nayak who was killed while trying to do his job, the gentleman being referred to by P.R. Dubeshi? Do you know the names of all these people? Do you know Amit Jetwa? Do you know Arun Sawant? Do you know Satish Shetty? Do you know Sola Ranga Rao? Have you gone back and do you care enough about how these people have been killed because they were pushing for the truth? In case you do, then this itself can be the basis of a campaign because death is not the price of honesty. We're following up the story tonight. If you're in Bengaluru, you tell us what you think. And irrespective of whether the Karnataka government will come on the news hour or not, we will take all your mail and we will send it straight to the Chief Minister's office. We want your feedback. What do you think about the way Mahantesh was killed in Bengaluru? I will await your feedback. To my gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.